Today, we have T.S. Ramakrishnan, who is a public policy analyst. He has been doing his research analysis in public policies and programs of union and the state government. He has got his doctoral degree from Indian Institute of Management from Ahmedabad. Today, we are going to talk about the various contributions and achievements of the union government.
I am Ramakrishnan, done my PhD from IIM Ahmedabad in public policy. I have been observing the developments of this government for the last 5 years. I would like to share with the people of India on some of the schemes and programs that have been implemented by the union government.
So, what is the approach that the government is following with respect to the health of the citizens of India?
The union government led by Mr. Modi has been following a unique and holistic approach towards health of people. Whenever people have to get admitted in hospitals on emergency and for serious illness, by introducing insurance scheme for 10 crore families, now they don't have to bother about the huge expenses that are waiting for them whenever they fall sick very seriously. We have to remember one more thing, that simply because we have insurance does not mean that we will be in a position to avoid all the hospitalization expenses, because premium comes at a price. The essence of any insurance policy is that if 100 people are paying premium for health insurance, they collect 5,000 rupees from 100 people and it comes to 5 lakh rupees, and they pay it for 2 persons who are hospitalized, say 2 lakhs, 2 lakhs, 4 lakhs. This is how the system works. So, when more and more people fall sick, the premium amount goes up, and that will be detrimental for the people, because they need to pay more premium. So, the best thing is always to prevent the diseases, and we know that when people are suffering from poor health, it results in what we call it as disability affected days. People are, when sick, they can't attend to work, and that is affecting the economic development, their income, the national economy and everything. So, it is a triangular approach that the government has been following in terms of providing insurance for the hospitalization, drugs at a lower cost, as well as promoting yoga, which is nothing but prevention is better than cure.
Jan Aushadhi drug stores. Sir, what do you think is so special about that?
Reduced medicines cost for the ordinary people. Because people, once they reach 40, 45, they have to depend on few medicines, some of the medicines for their survival till they live. So, by introducing Aushadhi drug stores all over India and manufacturing generic drugs against branded drugs produced by the private pharmaceutical companies, the government has reduced the prices of these drugs significantly. There are evidences to show that those who are almost spending 1,000 rupees per month for their regular medicines are getting it at 300 rupees from Aushadhi stores. The generic medicines are beyond patent period, and anybody can manufacture it, and there is no restriction on that. And the government took note of it, and the Department of Pharmaceuticals took this initiative and then doing it. The third component is with reference to prevention. Prevention is better than cure. So, if at all we look at our past with the present, in 1950s and 60s and even in 70s, India has been fighting against the so called communicable diseases, which are basically comes from outside. Now, in the last 20, 30 years, we have more lifestyle diseases than communicable diseases. We have almost eliminated all the communicable diseases, like whatever it may be, smallpox, malaria, cholera, and so many other communicable diseases. And now we are fighting with lifestyle diseases. And lifestyle diseases cannot be just managed with medicines and hospitalization and taking treatment. It should be by having a better lifestyle, and the better lifestyle can come only when the people are trained for such a lifestyle from their younger days. And this is where actually this government has been very successful in promoting yoga. By promoting yoga, especially among the children and among the youngsters, they see that they resort to better lifestyle at an younger age, and thereby they continue to enjoy better health for a reasonably longer time compared to their previous generation.
Why do you think Modi is focusing on popularizing yoga? Do you think as a prime minister it is one of prime duty for him?
It's a good question. You have been asking me why Modi should popularize yoga. Should it be the duty of the prime minister to popularize yoga? After all, yoga is good for health, but there is no need for the prime minister to popularize yoga. Even the prime ministers like Jawaharlal Nehru and Indira Gandhi and Morarji Desai practiced yoga in the past, and they have never popularized it. Except for Indira Gandhi, who has done some shows on Doordarshan in 1970s program on yoga practice. Otherwise, none of them ever propagated it. Then why Modi should do it? So this is the difference between 1960s, 70s and 80s and 2010s. At that time, we were suffering from communicable diseases, and the government has to spend more money, more energy and more time on attacking these communicable diseases like smallpox, malaria and other things. Whereas now the lifestyle diseases are more, and the government also has to change its policy. Now the policy has to be more towards promoting yoga, and yoga is a merit good. When we speak in terms of economics, merit good is one thing where the government has to provide it and should encourage people to follow it. So that is what we call it as merit good.
Some accuse that Modi promotes yoga just because of the fact that it belongs to Hindu tradition. Do you think it's a yes or a no?
There is no point in blaming Modi that Modi is promoting yoga because it has come from Indian culture or the so-called Hindu culture. Because more than India, yoga is being practiced by many other countries. People who are following different faiths, maybe Islam, Christianity, then Buddhism, they all follow yoga. So what is the problem in India following yoga when we know that India has given yoga to the world? We have to look at it holistically, and that is how it should be seen. There is no point in ignoring yoga because it is associated with the Indian tradition, or for that matter Hindu tradition. We have to see whether it is beneficial for us or not. If it is beneficial, we will certainly embrace it, and that is what we should do it.
Sir, what is the relationship between yoga, individual's health, wealth and nation's economy?
Of course, there is a relationship exists between yoga, personal wealth, personal health and nation's wealth also. Because when people fall sick because of poor lifestyle habits, their income goes down, their health goes down, their mental health as well as physical health goes down, and ultimately it affects the economy also, because people who are in the active age should contribute to the economy as much as they can. And if they fall sick very often, they are not going to contribute to the economy, and that will affect the nation's economy also. So yoga is not only going to affect individual health and wealth status, but also Indian's economy. That's the reason we should promote yoga, and the Prime Minister does it for the right reasons.
Sir, I would like to thank you for giving your precious time with us and letting us, common people like us of India, to know about the contributions and achievements done by the existing government. So as a policy decision maker, I think you have done an incredible job in research and analysis of how a government has spent their budget and allocated for the development of a country. So I would like to thank you, sir, once again.